I'm David Barber, a distinguished scientist at UiPath, and my role is largely to do algorithm development. So that is to create the next generation of tools and techniques that people at UiPath can use that eventually will filter through to the products. Agentic AI, from my perspective, is about making machines that can act actually in the world. So in AI, you know, we think about different kinds of systems, things that can understand, things that can reason, but also critically, a third element is actually things that can actually act. So if you think about us as intelligent beings, you know, we will kind of be impoverished if all we could do is understand things, but we could never actually carry out any actions. That would be kind of a little bit weird. So what we would like to do is, in AI, make these systems that then carry out these actions in response to interacting with humans. So agentic AI is essentially that, right? It's basically about making agents, typically there might be several of them, and these agents then can go out and carry out actions in the world. Large action models are essentially models which can just take actions in response to queries. So in large language models, which people are probably more familiar with, these machines have been trained on text, and they understand, you know, the textual world around us, so they know a lot about language, about facts, etc. And you can ask them to do amazing things, like generate responses or emails, etc. But if you're thinking about something like, you know, a business environment, you might actually want not just to compose an email, but actually to write some particular, say, response, or you might lay, you know, maybe I might need to do a database lookup. So if I told you, look, here's a set of tools that are available, which of these tools would you like to use at the current step? You might say, well, I might like to use a calculator, or I might like to use a flight booking tool, or I might like to use, say, some database lookup tool. So what the large action model needs to do is to understand what those tools are and when they can be used. So if I then ask a question, it will say, okay, to solve this question, I need to make a plan. I need to call this database, I need to get the answer from the database. I need to do maybe then some internet search, look at the results from the search, and then I need to call, say, some booking agent or whatever it might be. And so that overarching thing is then a large action model which understands how to carry out actions to complete a task. Agentic AI is very exciting and important because without having the ability to carry out actions, I think these systems are quite limited. So if you think about the world of work, right, that's what we do. Ultimately, we are carrying out actions, right? We are not just sitting there passively consuming things. We're actually creating responses to problems in the world of work. So without the ability to act, we're not going to do very well. So if we can figure out, make systems that can act in response to questions and carry out tasks in either an autonomous or a semi-autonomous way, that's incredibly valuable. And the whole world of work will actually change potentially from that, because these systems will then work with us to carry out tasks much more efficiently. If they understand the world of work and what's possible in terms of the actions that they can take, then that's an incredibly exciting future. So UiPath is approaching agentic AI from a couple of perspectives. One of them is that we're training our own large action models. So these are models that can take actions given a task. So for example, if you said to the system, can you book a flight from A to B, then the system will carry out this set of actions. For example, going to a web page and typing itself into the web page. Now eventually, hopefully, the machine will stop and you'll get a response. Either the flight's been booked successfully or it was booked not booked successfully. So you get a kind of a reward, you know, as to whether or not the system worked correctly. Now, that reward learning-based approach, in some sense, is very powerful, and people historically have had some success with that. But it takes an awful lot of time, an awful lot of training, an awful lot of compute to train those systems. So we've had some success with that, and others have as well. But at UiPath, we're working on other ways to train these systems in a much more efficient, data-efficient way. We're actually trying to get humans to help train these systems. So maybe the humans can give the system some hints to say, well, I'm going to show the computer how I would book a flight from, say, London to San Francisco, and the machine will then get some understanding, actually, of how to book flights. And with a very limited number of examples, what we can see is actually the machine starts to be able to generalize quite well. So then if it's able or asked to, say, book a flight from Berlin to Monaco, then it can actually do it itself. It doesn't require any additional human input. So we are building our own large action models, and we're doing that in a very efficient way.